Welcome, everybody, for this very special moment of the festival. It's a great pleasure to welcome all of you for this special award to Enrico Ghezzi. Before starting, just a few words to tell you how we will do that. We choose to give the award in this beautiful venue of Locarno Film Festival because it's one of the most cinephile theater of the festival and one of the most emblematic. But the only problem is that we don't have a simultaneous translation here, so we decided to do it in the Swiss way, which is a very beautiful way, in my opinion. Everybody will speak its own language and the other will understand or not, and that's it. So I will speak French, my mother tongue language. Pour moi, j'ai rencontré le nom de Enrico Ghezzi il y a très 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 longtemps quand j'étais une jeune cinéphile, et je pense que j'ai commencé par lire son nom en lisant des textes. Des textes notamment sur Daniel Huillet et Jean-Marie Straube, des textes sur Jean-Luc Godard, des textes sur Carmelo Bene, beaucoup de cinéastes qui ont fait partie des découvertes qu'on fait quand on commence à aimer le cinéma et à s'y intéresser. Ensuite, je l'ai vu au Louvre, où il y avait pour la première fois à Paris depuis des années une intégrale des films de Guy Debord, et il présentait les films. Et ensuite, quand je suis arrivée à Rome pour travailler là-bas, pour moi, c'était la première personne que j'avais envie de rencontrer, c'était Enrico Ghezzi, parce que c'était quelqu'un dont le travail de passeur était arrivé jusqu'à moi. Française. Et quand je suis arrivée à Rome, je me suis rendu compte de qu'est-ce que c'était que Fuori Orario, donc cette émission nocturne, cette espèce de nuit cinéphile qui dure encore, hein, mais qui fête cette année ses 30 ans. Et j'ai compris qu'avec cette espèce d'union nationale dont a très bien parlé Pasolini, qui a représenté la télévision pour l'Italie, Fuori Orario, c'était comme la cinémathèque des Italiens. Et même plus que ça, c'est avec le développement d'Internet, ensuite, c'était aussi une cinémathèque mondiale, parce que il y a beaucoup, beaucoup de films qu'on se passait sous le manteau, comme on dit, et qui avaient le petit sigle de Rai 3 et qui venaient de Fuori Orario. Donc j'avais très envie de commencer pour ma première édition avec un hommage, en tout cas, je ne sais pas comment appeler ça, mais un remerciement plutôt à Enrico Ghezzi. Et donc dans le festival, vous savez, il y a beaucoup de prix qu'on remet à des artistes, mais il n'y avait pas de prix qui convenait pour Enrico. Et comme je me suis dit que pour une personnalité aussi unique et aussi exceptionnelle, c'était bien de créer un prix pour lui, juste pour lui. Et donc on est très heureux de donner le prix de l'utopie, il premio dell'utopia, à Enrico Ghezzi, parce que c'est quelqu'un qui a réussi à mettre en œuvre, à faire exister dans notre monde une réelle utopie. Voilà, et je vous demande de bien vouloir l'applaudir une première fois. Merci Enrico, merci beaucoup. Et avant d'appeler tous nos invités, je crois que tu voulais dire un petit mot avant que ça commence.
C'est vraiment un petit mot, et ce n'est pas moi. Et, diciamo, è obsédant, è devenu obsédant dans les derniers, dans les mois plus récents. Et c'est un mot de un homme qui sonne comme ça. On ne saurait pas, non, sans pas. On ne saurait pas. On ne saurait pas, non, sans pas. On ne saurait penser à rien. On ne pourrait penser à rien. Et je trouve que c'est au milieu de grands nombres de manifestations, ces mots, ces phrases qui avaient inventé Spin, Alfred de Musset, c'était à moitié des années 850. Ecco perché. Questa frase di Musset fu ripresa par Eric Rohmer. Elle me semble tellement belle dans cette impossibilité flagrante que je n'ai pas pu, même ce soir, la pousser dedans. Tous ceux qui travaillent pas seulement sur les strictement cinéphiles, une phrase comme celle-là, je trouve que c'est quelque chose pour tout le monde. Ci vedremo meno possibile nel prosieguo da adesso e comincia il programma, secondo programma. Buona visione.
Et maintenant, j'ai le grand plaisir d'accueillir à mes côtés sur scène un grand programmateur et donc peut-être un enfant de Fuori Orario et quelqu'un que vous connaissez très 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 bien, Carlo Chatrian.
Buonasera a tutti. A Locarno forse non ci sono regole, quindi nonostante io sia italiano, sono un italiano un po' di provincia, cercherò di usare il mio povero inglese, così almeno anche gli ospiti che sono qui con noi capiranno. Enrico Ghezzi just talked about obsession, and this is one of the words that he used to convey his vision of cinema. And as you said, Lily, if I'm here, it's probably because me, from my tiny village in the mountain, I found, thanks to him, this place, this utopia. It was in a small box at night. It was like cinema is. Every single word possible, every single reality, every single story. And it was, first of all, for me, a way to become more aware of the world, but also aware to lose a way to lose myself through cinema. So even though my relationship with Enrico Ghezzi is not as strong as many other friends of my generation, I owe you, Enrico, everything. Thank you. I was very happy with your invitation, because not only because of being here with friends here in this theater, but also because we asked some friend of us to come. So maybe I will ask the first one, Albert Serra, to join me.
Well, thank you very much. Of course, we all know what Enrico has done for the citizens, especially the citizens in Italy, you know, thanks to the public TV, and it has a very important work. But I can also witness what he did for me and for other filmmakers. I started, like Lily said, watching some programs of the Rai 3 for Horario, you know, at the beginning of digital, that people was passing, as you said, these cassettes or these CDs with these emissions, and we and my friends, it was even before starting my career as a filmmaker, and me and my friends were totally shocked, because we were thinking, you know, this is a public TV, and what are these people, you know, they look like fanatics. You know, for us, it was very, very, really strange to think that in a public TV, that there could be these crazy people discussing these films, showing these films, and was already, you know, something very, very important to me. Then it happened that our paths crossed. I became filmmaker, and finally, you know, Rai 3, for Horario, show one of my films. You know, what was totally a great honor. I didn't expect. I think I didn't deserve at that time. Then I also met Enrico with Jean-Marie in Buti also, and he did something very strange. Also he. In Perugia, you remember, he paid a tribute to me. I only have made two films, and there was a tribute to Albert Serra and to Leos Carax, with only two films. And I was there with him. You know, for me, it was totally, totally shocking, and another thing of fanatism, you know, that of giving me the possibility. And I remember the prize was the elephant, an elephant of boot, you know, and this was the fright. And I spent, you know, crazy days with Leos Carax, and his wife was still alive there. And I remember that Enrico told me, talking about Pola X, he said, the shorter version, it's not very good, but the longer, it's a masterpiece. You know, what I said, what the crazy people, again, you know? And then, okay, I don't know. Also, I discovered a lot of his work through the Raro Video, the Raro Video editions, of especially Carmelo Bene and Warhol, and his name was also there in the booklets and everything, and I have all these DVDs that were very, very important to me. And he has been following here all the time, you know. I remember just last time this year in Cannes, you know, one of the first person in my screening that came inside the theater to congratulate me was him. So I was very proud and honored of this last meeting. So I want to thank you for all these things you did. Thank you for allowing me to be part of it. And thank you for your example of incorruptible integrity. Thank you very much.
Grazie. Le deuxième invité de cette remise de prix, c'est Jean-Claude Rousseau, et je l'appelle sur scène tout de suite. C'est qu'il a, préparé un petit discours.
Mes films, j'ose le dire, représentent plus que d'autres ces choses jamais vues, cose mai viste, qui compose avec audace les programmes de Fuori Horario. Mais il justifie aussi la parenthèse qui écarte le mot « jamais », car, chose extraordinaire, comme miraculeuse pour mon cas, dans mon cas, ces films finalement sont vus. C'est dire, cher Enrico, ma surprise quand on les demande, parfois loin d'ici, sous d'autres fuseaux horaires, où l'écoute planétaire de tes programmes n'est pas fuori orario. C'est dire à la question « Comment connaissez-vous mes films ?» c'est me répondre souvent « Je les ai vus dans l'émission de la RAI 3 que fait Enrico Gazzi. » Oui, Enrico, mes films te doivent beaucoup et c'est heureux de pouvoir te le dire aujourd'hui. Tu as inventé, avec la complicité de Roberto Turigliatto, une cinémathèque universelle, vivante, sans souci d'archiver, riche des rétrospectives les plus complètes, toutes aux ous, tout strobe et huillé, tout ce qui peut encore se voir des films lumière. Et tu jongles avec ces films comme sont jongleurs les cinéastes que tu aimes. Agile comme le fut Jean Vigo, à qui semble dédié chaque programme de Fuori Orario. Non pas habile, mais agile, dit Bresson dans la plus courte de ses notes sur le cinématographe. Et justement, c'est enfin évoqué un souvenir lointain, bientôt 20 ans, à l'époque où j'avais pris l'habitude de terminer l'année en passant quelques jours en Sicile. C'était précisément le 18 décembre 1999. J'étais à Catania. De retour à l'hôtel, un peu tard, je regardais à la télévision la présentation des quotidiens du lendemain. Revenait souvent en première page la photographie d'un homme dont la ressemblance avec Robert Bresson m'étonnait. C'était bien lui. On apprenait sa mort. Et tout au long de cette nuit de deuil, Fuori Orario, cose mai viste, illumina l'écran en projetant à la suite trois films de l'auteur des quatre nuits d'un rêveur. Merci, Enrico.
Merci, Jean-Claude. Maybe before introducing the next guest, just like to add something that the work of Enrico Gezzi and, of course, Enrico and his gang, for me, it was important also to give sense to the word programming, because it was not only about showing films that were difficult to see, at least again for people that, like me, a person like me that didn't live in a big town, but also to put together films, to put together raw material, to put together sequences, and to create a new meaning. So this is really something that I think for all my generation meant a lot. The other thing, on a more ironic note, is that I think this is something that all the people of my generation knows quite well. For some kind of cruelty, the Fuori Orario never start at the exact moment. So we were waiting, like it was like midnight 30, then 1:15, 1:30, and when it was the case of a very long film, more than 7 hours, so it was even more painful. And I remember clearly, I'm sorry, Bella, but the first time I watched your film, Satan Tango, was on a small screen. I remember exactly that night, and I think it was like half an hour late, the show. But this is also part of what Albert said, part of the obsession, part of the love that even at distance Enrico gave us. And so with no further ado, I'd like Bella Tarr to join us. Thank you.
I made few notes, just because I came to say thank you to Enrico. And okay, you can kill me. First of all, I would like to say a really big thanks for your sharpness, for your sharp eye, for your very strict taste, for your braveness. You were brave all the time, and you were uncompromised. You did not do any shit what everybody can do around the world. And you have to know, you were not only Italian, you were worldwide. You were influencing the young people because you invited them. You invited them to Taormina, to invited them to Lipari, you invited them to Perugia, you invited them a lot of places. You made it a bridge between the philosophy and the visual arts and the filmmaking. You were great. And I just wanted to say what you did and what you do is excellent. And we are all are lucky we can get this from you. And I have to tell you, you helped a lot for the young filmmakers. They felt sometimes lost. They needed support. They needed, sometimes when you were working in the RAI, you gave money. You supporting them and you helped them. And some masterpieces growed up because of you. And I have to tell you, sometimes it was hard to follow your brain. Sometimes we had a feeling you are crazy. No, you were faster than we all. And we learned it. We cannot be slow. We don't have so much time. Yeah. And I have to tell you, the main issue is you never respect any fucking rules. You never respect any shit which is driving us now. And that was the biggest support. Your mentality. And I just wanted to say a really big thanks, Enrico, for your being and for everything. And finally, really big thanks for your friendship. We met 25 years ago and we spent a lot of time together. And it was all moment still with me. And I hope we will spend more and more time. Okay.
This is, yeah, we go all together. Il premio dell'utopia.
No, it was just a little, but not so little joke. I was remembering that an open way in the prairie is all there and here. And for instance, the most precious and the strangest of cinema things passed on TV, but also in little cinema, also Perugia, for instance. But la chose la plus surprenante, c'est comme les 45 heures des rushes d'un film sont là pour attendre en attendant que l'histoire ne se termine pas. Et so if we are afraid of speaking always evermore. So the gardes ne peuvent pas éliminer ce qu'on peut faire dans l'ombre et que dans le cinéma peut devenir une pure beauté ou ce qu'on attendait.
Grazie tantissimo, Enrico. Thank you so much. And thank you to all of you. It's a celebration of freedom, also freedom of mind and imagination. You're, I think, a good programmer is a programmer with imagination, and you have a great, great imagination. So again, thank you a lot. And now we are going to see a program especially edited for the 30th anniversary of Fuori Orario. It's called La Macchina dello Spazio, the Space Machine. And I would like also to thank Roberto Turigliato very much for all his help all those months. Thank you. So I leave you with the images and the sounds. And thank you, Enrico.